Dear people of the Diocese of Townsville, since becoming the Bishop of Townsville in May 2017, I've had the delight of meeting so many of you. I've travelled the length and breadth of the diocese in the hope of understanding it better in terms of your hopes and dreams, your challenges and disappointments, your joys and sorrows. My recent road trip to the Midwest and West of the diocese convinced me of a great resilience in this part of the world. The drought has placed great pressure on families and communities. Whilst country towns may not be what they used to be, those who remain have not given up and retain a level of optimism that is truly an inspiration. With the decline in population and services, those who live in these once thriving communities have chosen to keep the dream alive, and for that I hold them in the highest regard. The church and its worshipping community is no different in terms of experiencing a decline in membership and practice. If the town is struggling, then so will the church, for obvious reasons. On the other hand, a thriving community will give the church new life as well. There are all sorts of reasons why our church communities are experiencing challenges today. You don't have to live in the Midwest and West to know this. The practice of the faith in terms of going to church is well down compared to what it used to be. Again, there are no easy or simple answers to that. Dear friends, what I'm sure of is that parishes will need to adapt to these changing realities. Leadership at local level is critical at this time, and whilst the priest or ordained minister has a critical role in this, he cannot possibly do it by himself. The priest needs to work in collaboration with his community, calling new people into a life of service as baptized Christians. Our baptism was never meant to be a private love affair between God and us, but a sacrament that reminded us of our responsibilities as members of the body of Christ, the Church. Every one of us hearing this message should be asking themselves, how can I be of service to Christ within this local worshipping community? How can I be a steward for the kingdom and give of my time, talent and treasure to the community of which I am a member? How can I take my rightful place, not in terms of simply helping Father, but joyfully giving back to God what God has already given to me? Our parishes, every one of them, need a new dynamism and purpose so that others may find them attractive and want to join our ranks. Some parishes are more successful than others in being attractive, yet our faith communities are always in need of reform, just as the Catholic Church is always in need of reform. The parish of 50 years ago is not the same parish today, which means that all of us must make an effort to examine what is working well in our parishes and what is not working so well. Perhaps some things need to die in order for new initiatives to emerge as we respond to the signs of the times and the new realities that are before us. The Church exists to evangelize, to spread the good news of Jesus Christ, which means that we must become an outward-looking church as opposed to an inward-looking one. Our strategies and ways of doing things will need to be reviewed if our parishes are struggling to remain vibrant and relevant. People need a reason to stay, and others need a reason to join us as fully-fledged members. In this sense, prayer with no action is not going to get us very far. As servants of the kingdom, not our kingdom but God's, we have an urgent responsibility to rise up and live our lives and our time and place in a holistic way. Whilst pastors and others usually only speak of stewardship in terms of time, talent and treasure, the truth is that stewardship involves all of life, body, mind and spirit, our material possessions, friendships, etc. All we are and have is a gift from our Creator for us to use wisely to build up God's kingdom here on earth. Henry David Thoreau once said, "It is not enough to be busy, so are ants." The question is, what are we busy about? What are our parishes busy about? Are we busy about the kingdom of God, about evangelization, about matters of practice? How do we use our time as parishioners? Of course, God has given each of us talents to share. What is your talent? Can you share this talent with your community? The third ingredient that every parish must consider is how it will remain financially viable into the future when the present is proving to be a financial difficulty. The truth is that many of our parishes are conveying the disturbing news to me that they are in financial difficulty. I came to know this shortly after I was made your bishop. Without question, this situation is untenable, and the clergy and parish finance councils are well aware of this. Hence my message to all of you. I really speak on their behalf and make a direct appeal to you. Your parish needs your financial help. In many cases, the mission of your parish is seriously underfunded. The salaries of clergy are just one component to be factored in. The diocese itself is carrying an increasing burden of costs that under normal circumstances should be paid by parishes themselves. Issues of maintenance to churches and other buildings are enormous. New safeguarding policies rolled out throughout the diocese are not cheap. Audits to do with asbestos, cladding and creating parish asset registers and other compliance requirements need to be funded from somewhere. The list goes on. Parishes, though, need some comprehensive responses to growing costs, and this means that the level of giving across the diocese needs to increase. Your parish cannot fund its mission at present levels. This is what many are telling me. On their behalf, then, I ask you to respond in an ongoing and regular way to this challenge. The Christian need to share our gifts of treasure, which I'm addressing now, is best illustrated by the well-known parable of the talents. Matthew 25, verses 14 to 30, speaks of a man preparing to travel to a far country. Before departing, he gives talents or money to his servants. The first servant receives five talents and works them into five more. The second servant, who receives two talents, doubles their value as well. The third servant, who received one talent, buries it. When the master returns, he praises the first and second servants, but he takes the one talent from the third servant because the servant was not a good steward of the money. The lesson of the parable of the talents is that we are to make good use of the material gifts given to us by God. To be less than frugal with our material goods is sinful. To do nothing with them is just as wrong. My friends, as your bishop, I have no choice but to raise this matter with you. Please hear my words in the spirit they are meant. I'm speaking them on behalf of others. Our parishes need your financial support. Clearly, income from collections is not matching expenditure. Projections do not look good, so something has to give. I pray for your communities. Many wonderful things are done in the name of Jesus Christ in this diocese that I have the privilege to serve. We do have challenges, but I and my collaborators are working hard to address them. In the meantime, the financial stress being experienced in many of our parishes must be spoken about. I trust that my words to you, spoken in good faith, will receive a sympathetic hearing, and that you will do what you can for the parish you love. Thank you for listening.